Hello, Internet. Today I'm gonna do the unboxing and the review of the TimeTrax Elite Bio. This time clock that you can use if you're running a small business, the good thing that it has is that it does not require to be connected to the internet at all times, not even to the network. You only need to have it connected to the network, not the internet, when you're gonna retrieve the punches at the end of the month. It prevents body punching by using biometric finger scans, which is technology that has been around for a while. I'm gonna proceed opening and unboxing so you can see what's inside the box and you want it to the network and do the initial setup. Let's check it out. I'm gonna open the box, see what's inside. And basically it comes with the time clock that we're gonna proceed to take out. So it's very basic and very powerful the way that it's set up. It has a screen that will light up to let the employee know whether the time punches have been successfully acquired. You can also punch using a numeric code. The employees can punch using numeric codes on this. And basically the employee will place their finger here and it will give a readout of who the employee is. On the back side, you have a power plug where you can connect to the power. It has regular mounting holes and screws. And on the back, you can connect the network and the BCD out. This is the basic layout on the back of the equipment. And basically we're gonna mount it like this, hanging on the wall. Let's see what else comes into the package. I'm gonna put this aside here. With it also comes the manual for the basic installation that we will get you through in a little bit so you can see how we install it on the wall of the client. The installation CD that I believe that we will have to download an updated version from the manufacturer. And also the power supply. So we will use to connect it permanently to the wall. And a network cable that you can use to connect to the network. It also comes with the standard mounting hardware. So you can mount this plate on the wall first and attach it with screws. And a warranty manual. Let's power it on for a second and make sure that it powers on so you can see the initial screen. And basically this is where the employees will see. If I had a fingerprint register, it will recognize who I am. But obviously since I haven't registered, it will say not found. So basically on the screen, what the employee is gonna see is the time and the day that they're clocking in for. The time is not accurate. So we'll have to reprogram it later on. It syncs with the time on the computer. So I'm gonna proceed, drive to the client's location and install it so you can see how we mount it on the wall and how we set up the software to facilitate the acquisition of employees' biometric fingerprints. I'll see you in a moment. Let's drive to the client. So we already got the hardware installed on the wall, the time clock itself. I'm going to proceed to install the software that we're going to have on our workstation to be able to pull out the time records for the employees on each pay period. The setup is still really simple. So I'm gonna start up the CD setup by clicking on TimeTrax setup. This will also, if you have auto run enabled, it will run by itself once you start up the CD. So here I'm greeted with the welcome to the TimeTrax version 5 setup wizard. I'm gonna hit next to install it to the default location. And let's just surf through the screens and make sure that we get it installed. It will install a few requirements like SQL Server, and it has been successfully installed. Click finish. So we already got the software set up. I'm gonna click on the icon to start it up, and let's go through the options for the initial setup. It will go through the installation of IIS 8.0 Express. So once you open it, it will show up on a web page. You do not need internet to run it. It runs locally on the workstation. And you're gonna enter the default username and password, which is on the CD. And it should be uppercase admin, and the password is PTI. I'm gonna choose not to save the password. And it's gonna ask me for permission if I have a firewall. So this is the dashboard for the TimeTrax 5.0. We need to enter our employees and all the details for the company on the pay periods and the payroll. The dashboard, to make sure that your time clock is being recognized and found on the network, you're gonna click on clock, and you're gonna click on hardware manager. And as you can see, my time clock has already been detected. Here is the device name, the model of the time clock, how it is connected via Ethernet, the firmware version that is running, and it says that it's online, meaning that it can connect to the time clock. Let's check out the details. By clicking on detail, and we can see the status. And this is the last update where it connected to the time clock. This is the time on the device, which is wrong. We need to update it. I'm gonna edit the properties of the time clock to see what I can change. The time zone settings were incorrect. By going into the device settings, I'm going to enable NATP, so it pulls out the time from the internet, and I'm gonna put the correct time zone that I'm using for this client, which is the Pacific time, UTC-8. Save the settings and let it update into the time clock. And it comes back with a notification that the configuration has been successfully sent to the device. In case you have several time clocks, it will let you see here the MAC address of the device that was updated. I'm gonna also change the name to a more friendly name so I can remember, and I'm gonna rename it Wall Clock. Going to save it again. And it comes back saying again that the device settings have been updated to the time clock. So now that you have completely finished the installation of the time clock and the software, we are going to proceed to do the basic setup of the company and the settings for the employees.
Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, subscribe to my other channels on technology, web design, general life in Los Angeles. Thank you so much for watching. I would love to see you again.